Hello students, after a long time. So hope you all are fine and healthy. So students, today we are going to start a new chapter. So before that, let me ask you some questions. The name of the chapter, I am not writing it now or I am not telling you now. So let us do one activity. It's not a hands-on activity. Just few questions will be there to you. So students, let me draw this figure. As we all know, this is a triangle. Now, let me divide this triangle in two parts. So I have divided this triangle in two parts. So suppose this part is green shaded. And this part is, I've shaded red. So students, if I ask you, total how many parts are there? You will say two parts. Out of two parts, how many parts are green? That means total parts is two. Out of two parts, how many parts are green? One part is green. See here, I have written 1 by 2. I have written 1 by 2. As we already discussed in the previous classes, we call this as a numerator. And we call this as a denominator. So this is named as numerator, this is named as denominator. So as a whole, how will I express, what name I can give to this number 1 by 2? As a whole, what will I say this? This number is said fraction. That means I have divided a diagram in two parts. So one part is green. So how will I express the green part? I will write 1 out of 2. So this is called fraction, where I will get numerator and denominator. So what we are going to learn? We are going to learn fraction. Today we are going to learn fraction. So students, we will be learning fraction now. As we discussed about fraction, there are two things come. One is numerator, another is denominator. You have done it in the previous classes. So students, let us go to some questions now. So we are going to learn fraction. So students, now let me draw another diagram. This is the diagram. I have divided this diagram into 4 equal parts. This is one. Suppose this I say red part. Suppose this is blue part. Suppose this is green part. And suppose this is yellow part. So I have separately, I just mentioned the colors. I didn't color the parts. I have just mentioned red portion. This is red portion. This is blue portion, we can say. This is yellow portion, we can say. And this is this is green portion, this is yellow portion, and this is blue portion. Let me say this. Now, few questions arises in my mind that you are going to answer. So students, question is this. Express red portion in fraction. Express red portion in fraction. So how will I express? So now, first of all, I say that you have to express this red portion in fraction. When it comes fraction, I will get numerator and denominator. So now, denominator, So it means total portion is how many?
First of all, I'll think about that.
1, 2, 3, 4.
There are 4 portions are there.
So I will write total portion is 4. So now, how many red portions are there?
1. 1/4.
So how will I express
the red portion?
Red portion I will write as a
1/4. We can say this is 1/4.
This can be named as 1/4.
Okay.
Now, this, in this way, we name the fraction. So now, types of fraction we will be learning in the next class. Now, students, first of all, let us clear about fraction. What is a fraction? So now let us go to the another question. Another question is, suppose this is a cake. Suppose this is a cake. This is a cake. Now, this cake is divided into 4 parts. Like this. Sachin at.
Question is, Sachin at 1/4 of the given cake.
1/4 of the given cake.
Sachin at 1/4 of the given cake. So what portion will left out?
What portion will left? What portion will left? Express.
Can we express that portion in diagram?
Can we express that portion in diagram? Question is this. Sachin at 1/4 of the cake. That means, suppose this part Sachin at. So how many left? That means, he had this part. He had this part. Now how many part left?
3 part. Actually, there was 4 part. There were 4 parts.
Out of 4 part, 1 part,
Sachin already ate 1 part.
Out of 4 parts, Sachin already ate 1 part. So how many part will left?
3 part will left.
That means 3/4. So it is given that Sachin ate 1/4 of the cake. What portion will left?
3/4 or 3/4.
So can we express this in diagram?
Yes.
Diagram is this one. This is the diagram. We can express. This is the diagram. You can draw this diagram. Here, it's a whiteboard, just I rub this portion,
but you cannot rub it, you have to draw it once again.
So students, in this way, we express, fractions. So now, let us discuss one more question based on fraction. Now, this is the triangle. Again, I have given the colors red, blue, green, yellow.
Question is this, can we express the part that you have, if you give
the yellow part to Harry,
to Harry, if you give yellow part to Harry, then
what fraction you have given?
Then what fraction you have given? If you give yellow part to Harry, then what fraction you have given?
Total 1, 2, 3, 4. Total 4 parts are there.
How many parts I have given to Harry? Only 1 part. That means yellow part I have given. Yellow part I have given to Harry. That means 1 part I have given to Harry. That means what fraction I have given?
1 by 4.
So now it is given that, can you draw the remaining part after giving the yellow part? Can you draw the remaining part?
Here it is very simple, I'll rub it. The remaining part will look like this.
But you have to draw it. You have to apply your thinking capability. When you give this part, then how much part will left? So hope, student, you have understood this. So your homework will be uploaded in the Google Classroom. So thank you and have a nice day.